So that brings us to electric cars. So in New Zealand, there has recently been some promotion by the government to do something with electric cars, and so politicians will get out for these sorts of opening of a new fast charging station, and we've got quite a lot of fast charging stations around New Zealand, almost enough to drive almost anywhere, depending on what model of electric car you've got. So if you've got a long range electric car like a Tesla, and Tesla recently came to New Zealand, then you can basically drive anywhere in New Zealand with a Tesla car. There's lots of places you can recharge. There are some Tesla supercharger stations, and they're building kind of a corridor through the middle of the North Island with Tesla superchargers, and the first ones are in Hamilton. And that's about 100 or 150 kilometres from Auckland, the biggest city in New Zealand. So heading to Hamilton is somewhere where people might go for a weekend away, so you know, or even a day trip for work. But otherwise, we have a network called ChargeNet, and ChargeNet operates chargers and a billing system. So the billing system's the important thing. What you want is when you're trying to use rapid chargers to take a trip around New Zealand where you might need to recharge your car several times, you want it so that you can just walk up to the charger, activate the charger, plug your car in, and quickly charge and then go. And so the ChargeNet system has sort of taken hold in New Zealand, and have started rolling out their whole network of chargers. So at this point, this is the point where I think it's the right time for me to buy an electric car. So as I'm got this sort of background in electronics and computer science, you know, electric car is the direction I want to go. I've had a hybrid car for a long time, 3 or 4 years, and hybrid cars are great because they're very cheap to run and generally have low maintenance costs. But since I live in a country where there's ample supply of electricity, electric car is where I want to go. In New Zealand at the moment, there's about 5 million people and about 3,000 electric cars, so pretty early days. I would say that of the approximate 5 million people in New Zealand, about 3 or maybe 4 million seem to have cars. A lot of people have more than one car in New Zealand. In New Zealand, you know, people are moderately wealthy on a world standard, and if you want to have two cars just because you feel like having two cars, that's something that people will do. Some people will have a cool car that they drive on the weekend, or a big four-wheel drive they use for towing their boat or going on holidays. You know, have camper vans and utility vehicles and trucks and vans. We have everything. So New Zealand's a very open market economy, so we have almost any car that you can buy in any country is available in New Zealand, and there's not a restriction to importing cars. So if you see a car when you're overseas and you really want to bring it in, you can bring it in. There's paperwork and conversions and compliance and all of that, but generally there's nothing stopping you from having any car that you want if you really want it and if you've got the money to buy it. And for a lot of New Zealanders, having the money to buy a car is something that, you know, a lot of people generally have. So you know, you can, if you're enthusiastic about any car, you can have any car. A lot of people I know have pretty cool cars, and you know, they just go through whatever car. If they feel they want a car for a while, they'll buy it and keep it for a few years and then sell it again. In New Zealand, there's not really any special taxes for cars. In some countries, there's all these government plans to, if you buy an economic car, then you can get a tax discount and all of that kind of stuff. Mostly that doesn't apply in New Zealand. We just don't really have any of those incentive schemes. So we have a kind of a fairly fair market, an actual market. So you can kind of have any car. There's not really any major costs associated. there's no, I don't know that there's any luxury car taxes or anything like that that they have in some countries. What we do have for certain types of vehicles, you pay an annual fee for owning a car registration. That gives you your number plate that you stick on your car, and every year you have to go back and pay that fee. And you can pay it quarterly, but it's cheaper if you pay it a year at a time, just slightly cheaper because it's slightly less paperwork. So generally, that fee has a little bit built in, and it's generally to do with the safety of a car, not much anything else. So newer cars tend to have somewhat lower fees, and cars that have crazy performance that people tend to crash a lot have higher fees because there's a bit more of a danger factor built in there. And the reason why we have that is because we have an accident compensation system in New Zealand. So if you have an accident in a car and you need medical care, then the medical care is provided by the state in general. Most people don't have private medical insurance, and most people don't have private medical insurance that would cover emergency care. So in these registration fees, there's a part which is called the ACC levy, which is calculated by how often people crash the kind of car that you have and how badly they get injured. So old rubbish cars have higher fees, new higher performance cars that people like to crash often have higher fees, but if you've got a very conservative car that's very safe, then it tends to have lower fees. But these fees are only hundreds, perhaps even $60. So the fee is very low. It's not like when you live in countries, I think Singapore and sort of Hong Kong and China have these huge vehicle registration fees that, you know, for a lot of people, you have to save up for a year to even be able to buy a car. Whereas in New Zealand, the fee is quite trivial compared with the cost of running a car and buying a car. But that said, cars in New Zealand are actually moderately cheap in a market. Some cars are expensive and some cars are cheap, but we get a lot of second-hand cars. About half of the market comes from buying second-hand cars from Japan and bringing them in directly. And then we have a lot of car yards that sell a mixture of new and second-hand cars, and the second-hand cars come into the country after they've just been used for a few years. Often not more than, say, 7 years. Importing more cars that are more than 10 years old from Japan's not really done. The government tends to adjust safety regulations so that cars that are being imported, even second-hand cars, have to have most of the very modern safety systems built into the car. So, airbags and strengthened crumple zones. And over my lifetime, certainly the safety of cars has massively increased, and especially in the last 10 years when airbags just were common on everything and ABS braking. As second hand cars have come into New Zealand, the safety requirements of the cars have had to quite closely follow the safety requirements of new cars, but something like a 5-year delay. At the same time, we've been building better roads. So there's a lot of, a lot of the highways are planned by central government, and there's been a lot of improvements to roads. And also there have been some road safety campaigns where dangerous roads have been kind of shamed into upgrades. And everybody knows there are roads in the country that are just considered to be, oh, that terrible, dangerous road, be careful when you're driving down there. Everybody drives like crazy on that road for whatever reason. Quite often the case is that the road carries much more traffic than it was designed for. It doesn't have very many safe places to pass, and a lot of frustrated drivers just will drive badly because they get sick of following other traffic. I've certainly been on some of these roads that are considered to be bad roads, and more than one time I've been driving on a road with yellow lines which you're not allowed to pass on, and you come around a blind corner and there's somebody passing some other car driving in your lane coming head on towards you, and that just shouldn't be there. Really have diverged from the topic.